It is almost too wonderful that I cannot clearly, or at least I could not until I thought about it, remember what day this is. I have been spending day after day after day living by a calendar of when a museum is closed or when an attraction is open late at night. Not washing my clothes in the noisy washing machine in the middle of the night, but only washing them in the daytime. Going out for walks, not worrying in these neighborhoods too much about the hour. I can tell you that today is Wednesday, the 22nd day of October in the year of our Lord Jesus Christ, 2014. And that I am still in Paris, but I only have 7 more days. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, a week from today, will make 7 days. The next morning, I must go to the airport and spend the whole of Thursday, the 30th of October, traveling home again. Tonight, the Louvre is open until 9:45, and I am going there. And at 9 o'clock, I have a date to meet the New Zealander, Troutman Brown, or whatever his name is, Derek, in the Louvre, in front of the Mona Lisa. But until then, I leave you with this thought. Paris is beautiful. From the tip of its finger to the very toe of its bottommost boot, Paris is beautiful. I am here in the Lyon collection, and I wanted to show you this particular painting. It's a scene of the interior of a household, and there's no person in it except for the portrait hanging on the wall, but there are signs of people. Here on the floor, you can see a pair of sabots, of shoes that have been left. And hanging in the door is a set of keys. One wonders, where is the mistress or the master of the house? Are they just in one of the 3 rooms that we're looking through? Or have they gone for good? Thank you. I've been trying to figure out this room, especially the ceiling. There's some old guy got up there. And then, over here, I think that is spring. And over in the other wall of the ceiling would be summer. And then, of course, autumn. She's got the cornucopia and the harvest, which leaves one above my head, which is gonna be winter. Now the rest of the room is done all around with these babies floating on the wall, a pair of mirrors facing off against each other, and you see there's spring up there over that mirror. More babies. There's a little baby dressed up like a Roman soldier. And, of course, the mirrors. Incredibly tall doors. Windows looking out into the courtyard. And windows looking out onto the river. The river. I was here a week or so ago, shot the same scene, but I don't think I showed you this fabulous glassware from the 3rd and 4th century. This is glass that the Romans used. Look at that beautiful. Looks like you could just have a nice cold drink in it. Yeah. It's a cup. And then some elegant bottles. But there's more. Look at this. Fabulous pieces of glass. Beautifully decorated. From the 1st century. And it's in, remember, this room of the palace. Just these two cases and some window boxes displaying what you may think is just glassware. But it's actually quite priceless. being not only so incredibly delicate, but almost 2,000 years old. These are the kinds of dishes that the Roman aristocrats would have known. And over there is some of their jewelry. This room is connected like all of these rooms of the palace are connected one to another. Official proclamation of the foundation of the Louvre as a national museum, not just a royal collection. And here, the entrance to the gallery of the Apollo. This door, outside these windows, the palace courtyard, and there's the pyramid, but beyond through this door over here, it's incredibly tall door, into a great staircase, which is where you will find one of the greatest treasures of this museum. Era celebrating a naval victory, probably in the 2nd or 1st century BC. From this place, you can either go that way, which will lead you through Italian painting to the Grand Gallery. Or you can go over there, which will lead you to the gigantic French paintings and take you to the door to the Mona Lisa.